Hi, since I thought people might find this useful or at least interesting, I decided to make this video explaining my itch making process. What is an itch, you may ask? Itch is short for your character here. An itch is a type of commission that entails paying an artist to put your character on an already made base solely made for this purpose. So remember, itches aren't bases for the general public to use. Now to the fun part, showing you my process. Getting the idea. I already have planned out most of the itches for the final months of 2021 and the first 6 months of 2022. I'm a seasonal itch maker, so that means all my itches have a season or a holiday theme to them. From Christmas to Valentine's Day to Pride Month, I have it all planned. I usually get ideas randomly while working on other things. If you are familiar with my channel, you'll know that I usually try to make a special video for Halloween, Christmas and Valentine's Day, and maybe other holidays if I have the time every year. This gives me plenty of inspiration for upcoming seasons. Sometimes it helps to look at others' work, not necessarily itches, but art in general. I consume plenty of artistic content in my spare time, so that helps. Making the base doll. Since I made a small base sketch when planning out the idea, it will be easier to figure out the proportions of the final sketch. This itch is quite simple. There's a leaf falling down on the character's nose, ignore the lack of nose, and then blinking when it happens. In this stage, I try to make the pieces as customizable as possible, which means keeping most of the layers intact. It might come as a surprise to the people who have seen my itches before without checking the software I use, but I use Paint or Sight version 2 to make the base doll. It would be easier to use Photoshop, but I do not understand that software and I don't think I ever will. Animating the itch. Animating, I first take the Sight file, merge down the layers and save it as a Photoshop file while remembering to keep the original file intact for possible adjustments. Since I make clean pixel avatars, my movement options can be quite limiting. If you are planning to animate them like I do, you have to take into account the movement of the doll pieces from the start. I don't recommend getting too ambitious with the movement if you want to complete multiple ones. It might seem like a good idea at first, but you'll hate yourself later for it if you did what I did in the eventful days of December 2019. I can only speak in the case of twin itches. I can only imagine the hell of finishing a frame by frame itch. Finishing an itch. So you made a beautiful itch that you're proud of. Now what? Make an example, of course. Not all itches require samples, but I like making them. It means I can get familiar with how I can make my work easier in the drawing stage, and I also figure out how animating a complete itch should work. I usually go straight up into drawing the new parts of the character, no sketching, no nothing. Sometimes I might sketch out certain parts of the character. The character is particularly difficult. Usually the hardest part of the itch are the eyes. Since I make them pretty detailed, I have to shift the hues and make the colors actually look good together. It's even harder when the character has eyelashes. Animating a finished itch. Since I decided to torture myself in an attempt to avoid using Photoshop, I have to animate it separately, which means a lot of going back and forth between the base itch and the finished itch, which can be a pain depending on the amount of frames. I usually try to keep my itches between 6 to 8 frames, but some need up to 20 to look coherent. Done! Hope you enjoyed the video. I'll be linking the itch I made in this video below. Maybe some of you might like to get one. You could also drop a like, maybe even a subscription. Bye!